It's a shame, isn't it? Beautiful neighborhood, nice park for kids to play when it isn't stinking.
St. Louis has a nuclear past as a uranium processing center for the atomic bomb. Just Moms STL, a group of mothers turned advocates, believes their communities are being poisoned and demands that the government either remove the waste or permanently relocate the residents living nearest the landfill along Coldwater Creek in North St. Louis County. This HBO documentary you've been watching there, Atomic Homefront, is featured at the Whitaker Film Series this week for the St. Louis Filmmakers Festival. Rebecca Camissa is director of the HBO documentary, Atomic Homefront. Hi, Rebecca. Thanks for being with us. What drew you to this particular topic?
Well, I actually didn't really know anything about it, and someone I knew told me about what was going on, and I really didn't believe it when I first heard it.
So you're not from St. Louis?
I'm not.
Yeah, this is. It's been in and out of the news for many, many years.
Yes, it has.
In St. Louis about whether the EPA or the Army Corps of Engineers, who should accept responsibility for cleanup, et cetera. What are we learning through your documentary?
Well, I think what the film does is tells the story of two communities. One is a community that lives in Bridgeton, right around the landfill. So part of the film focuses on their struggle to get to the truth or find out, are they being harmed, or is what they are afraid of really taking place? And they're being told constantly that, no, everything's fine, everything's safe and managed, and it's okay, you're not at risk. So that's one community. The other community is the communities adjacent to Coldwater Creek, which were historically contaminated from Laddie Avenue radioactive waste that was kept there and then washed into Coldwater Creek. So the film interweaves these two communities trying to get to the truth about what's going on.
And getting to that truth, were you able to get to government officials or some government documents?
Yeah, well, there's a plethora of government documents. I think the stickier wicket is getting agencies and officials to go on camera and speak about it. The one agency that did was the Army Corps of Engineers. We filmed with them. They did do an on-camera interview. But just about every other agency or entity or regulating authority or politician would not go on camera with us.
Okay. So what you're doing is bringing a kind of a national light, if it's going to be on HBO, to a problem in St. Louis that has been pretty serious for years, and that it needs to be regulated, or it needs to some attention, some other kind of attention than it's getting.
Yeah, when I first came, which was in August of 2014, but even when I started researching the story, I thought, why is this not a national story? I mean, if it is potentially dangerous, and this is an unprecedented situation, why isn't it garnering more attention? So that was my thought. So we're very grateful, first of all, that Cinema St. Louis is showing the film here, because this is the first opportunity people from St. Louis will be able to see the film. But secondly, I'm glad that HBO decided to air the film, because yes, finally, nationally, it will get attention. And the people that are suffering through what they're suffering will get some validation.
Mm-hmm. All right. It's the HBO documentary Atomic Homefront. It is coming to HBO, but you can see it first right here in St. Louis tonight at 7:30 at the Tivoli Theater.
Right.
All right, Rebecca, thanks so much for being
with
us. Good luck with the film. Thanks so much for being with us. All right, we're coming right back. Stay with us.
It's a shame, isn't it? Beautiful neighborhood, nice park for kids to play.